What's going down, cultivators? It's Steven here dropping in with the living legend, the studio manager himself, the man who needs no introduction. How you doing?
I'm doing good. Sorry, I got the giggles because Jalen's on the switcher. I feel like Jalen's always on the switcher when I'm here now. Yeah. And it's making me giggle every time. So what it started out with, when I used to live in like a river town in California. It's kind of like the country, I guess. And, you guys are familiar with the country out here in Texas. There's not really much to do. So let's rewind a little bit before I moved to the river town. So I lived in another city, and my neighbor was a virtual tour photographer for giant real estate homes. And I didn't have a job, and he offered me a job to be his assistant. So I learned all my camera, basic camera knowledge through him. But before he took me out on shoots, he would have me edit his photos, and he would take panoramas like old school style, where he would take a picture, a picture, a picture, a picture, and I would put them together, make sure everything looked well. And instead of like now, you can just use the iPhone and just do this. Yeah, so we had to do it old school. So then I got real good at editing those and uploading and got the system down. And then he's decided to start taking me out on shoots. And so that's when he gave me my first camera. Fast forward a little bit, back to the river town. There's nothing to do out there other than getting wasted.
Or get bit by a spider.
Oh, well, so at that time, everybody was a skater. Oh, I shouldn't say skater. They were fruit booters. I don't know if you know what that means. Yeah.
I've heard of the term, but I'm not familiar.
Rollerbladers. And I was the only person longboarding. So that gave me an opportunity to longboard with the rollerbladers, and I had a camera. So that was my first like dolly shot stuff. So we would go around and I would make skate videos for them. They would go to the skate park. I would shoot stuff. And then eventually we started making treks to downtown San Francisco, and we would be hooligans, like literal hooligans. I would follow them around on my longboard. They would go and grind on rails, and we would get yelled at by like security. We're like, hey, there's no skating here. And we're like, we're going by. Yeah. So then eventually I started doing more of those, and then that turned into me trying to make fake videos, but meaning like fake UFO videos or fake ghost videos. Okay. And then from there I started learning like visual effects. So I at one point I was able to clone myself. I have videos of me playing Rochambeau, rock, paper, scissors by myself.
That's fire.
And then the first short film that I made, it was kind of a creepy, scary movie thing. And all my friends got involved, which was pretty cool. So the whole premise was the high point of this short film was me looking into the mirror. And then I look down, but the mirror reflection stayed looking. Yeah, you know what I mean. Yeah, so that started out my whole, like, all right, let's do like movie magic. And then eventually YouTube wasn't enough. And then that's when I decided to leave there and then go to school. Wow. Yeah, and then school was school.
School.
Yeah. Was it cool? I don't know. Maybe it was cool. I mean, it's got to be cool.
I mean, if you learned what you learned, then it's got to be cool.
Yeah. So I kind of just did what I learned what I wanted to learn and honest.
Just fucked off after?
Yeah, I didn't even graduate, to be honest with you. Yeah, I don't have a degree or a certificate in it. I learned what I learned, and then I just took it and went.
That's fire, though. I mean, at least you got what you needed to.
Yeah.
That's what matters. Because school's not always for everybody. So, I mean, if you can really get the premise of what you want to learn and then just head out.
Yeah.
Ain't nothing wrong with that, in my opinion.
No. I mean, and also my thinking was like, as a creative or like a video person, a cinematographer, director, whatever, what have you, they're not going to be like, You got a 2-year degree?
Yeah,
no. Nah, like, no, nah, dude. Like,
hey, can you make magic on the camera though? Yes, I can.
Not yeah. good, but yeah. And so the cool thing about school, I got to work with you ever watch Ratatouille?
Of course.
Yeah, I'm name dropping now. Jim Capobianco, he was one of the writers for Ratatouille, and he throws on a children's film festival every year. So I got to learn how to teach kids how to do stop motion animation using various products or not products, various things around the house, whether it's socks or Legos or whatever, or sand or anything. Yeah. And so we did that. And then eventually I got hired on at an after school program teaching just that. And I have a bunch of videos with kids there, but I keep them unlisted because, you know.
Yeah. So how were you able to make a difference in that part of the community then?
I honestly have not changed since then. I mean, you see how I'm like, you got an idea? I'll help you film it. I'll help you film it. You want me to do this? I'll help you film it.
Is that how someone was for you when you were coming up? Or
was that what?
Was that how someone was for you when you were coming up?
No.
Oh. Okay. So you kind of learned like, shit, I'm going to be there for others that people weren't for me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And that's one thing I've noticed about this industry is there's a lot of gatekeepers and a lot of it's very clicky.
That's
you know what I mean? But at the same time, if you are a director and you've always worked with this one video director of photography this whole time, you're not going to want to change that. Okay. I totally get that. But that turns into a click, and then the click turns into gatekeepers, and then that's how you can't get any jobs out there because everyone already has their crew and they're not trying to help anybody else out type deal. So at that point, I was like, I don't care who I work with. As long as they're punctual, they listen, and they can at least mesh with the groups that I'm, you know, or I usually pick people that can mesh with anyone.
Yeah.
I shouldn't say I dealt with assholes. I've had people on crew that were assholes, but still was a team player type deal.
Well, that's good.
Yeah. So I learned how to like notice like who's a team player and who's not, and then just go from there.
So what kind of role has that played for you now being studio manager here?
Well, at this point, like, I can pretty much work with anyone. That's really what that is.
Yeah. How do you view the team since you've been here?
Well, fun fact, this is the first team I've worked with since school.
Wow.
And school was like over 12, 15 years ago.
Pretty much almost my life.
Yeah, I've been solo the whole time.
Wow.
From the time I left school to now.
So now what's the culture like in the team that you're in?
Oh, it's everything that I wanted. Yeah. Like I think Jalon commented on one of my posts after the showcase saying that like I didn't know I needed a team until I got a team that was actually really good. Because before that, I've tried to make teams. I tried to assemble the squad. I tried to make Avengers. You know, I tried to do the Avenger initiative, but I either got flaked on last minute. Literally, when I say last minute, not day before,
like day of the show.
Day of the show, but like hours before the show, and I'm like, nah, dude,
it did help you because now you're a one man production crew. So
it did, but it gets tiring,
but
dude.
Like, fuck, man, who wants to actually do that?
I mean, I still love it
now, especially. But I mean, back then at the time, you're like, man, you're supposed to be dependable. I can count on you, you know, like. So I can imagine you felt some.
That's where I picked up the philosophy of like, no second chances, because fool me once, whatever. Fool me twice, I'm stupid.
Yeah.
Whatever, yeah, you know what I mean.
Stupid,
yeah.
That's a big thing. And so, do you have a story where you were really able to change somebody else's game through your teachings, or even just something you've produced? Like I know, for instance, that music video we shot with Shame on Me that blew them up. I know a lot. That was beautiful.
And that was their very first music video.
Really?
Yeah. I wouldn't say I changed their game up, but. Because you've seen them. They're amazing. They're like they're going to blow up whether or not I'm there.
That's very true. They're wonderful people. Yeah. Mel and everybody else. Shout out to y'all. If y'all are watching this, shout out to you.
Yes. I love you, Mel.
Like seriously, shout out.
I love you, Ro. Pat. And Jules. Sorry. No, I mean, Honestly, I don't really think of me doing video in that way. I just want to work with people that's fun to work with and who reciprocate the love, not necessarily doing a favor for a favor, but just like, just warm, loving family love.
Yeah, I mean, it's community. It's like, I've realized now through being an intern here is like, the more I help the network, the more I'm helping myself. Mm-hmm. Like just being there, showing up for myself, showing up for everybody else in turn leads to more opportunity, more praise, more people to work with. And it's just like, it's a never ending cycle of love and, you know, humility.
Yeah. And how could you not want that?
Right. Seriously.
In any environment, industry, like, or whatever. Yeah. Yeah.
Right. It's a wonderful thing to have, I'd say. Especially when, you know, your back's against the wall at some point in time. It's like, I just watched Spider-Man 2 in theaters. Mm-hmm. Wonderful movie. I love that movie. Definitely, I can say. I needed to watch it.
We've been dropping Marvel, like, gems all day.
In the same day that I watched this movie, I had some conversations with, like, Jar and other people here at the studio that were very similar to the ones in the movie. I shed a tear because it made me realize, like, even if my back's against the wall, stopping this train, I have the power of a community just carrying me up through it, no matter what. They don't help me get back up so I can help them go places they never imagined.
Yeah, no, it's a beautiful, beautiful, very beautiful feeling. And it's addicting.
It is.
You know?
It's like a drug, helping people.
Yeah. And I didn't know that that's the thing I was trying to look for this whole time being solo, or trying to reach out to people, assembling a team. But no one ever wanted to be part of that. Or even if they, yeah, I'm not going to go into the negatives because this is such a positive, like, conversation. I don't want to be like,
you know, fuck these people.
Yeah, yeah, no. Yeah, it's definitely a fun thing to do. And just being able to help people is awesome.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. So you have any advice for anybody that's just starting out, or what would you say?
I mean, it's not going to be anything original. Just go out there and do it. You know what I mean? Like, I would say if you can find a team right away. But that's not to say you should do stuff on your own. Because I think my journey was perfect for me because I'm an introvert in addition to everything else that happened and allowed me to be solo. But find your style first and then find other people that have like mind for that style, or the willingness to
adapt
to that style, or learn how to be able to help other people in their styles, so you can help other people develop their style while developing your own style.
You become a multimodal visionary at that point. Like, there's no stopping you once you can help everybody and their different outlooks and intrinsic values and all that.
Yeah, yeah.
It's really crazy.
No, I mean, I like to think of myself as a baker, not in that kind of big. Yeah. But like,
I mean, we best believe.
What are you laughing at over
We're
there?
We're definitely running Pokemon Showdown. I'm gonna kick your ass.
I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. I'll let you think that. But back to the baking thing. Like, anytime I get a new client, I always say, send me as much information as you can.
Whether your ingredients.
Huh? Yeah. Yeah. Exactly.
Right. You're dry.
Yeah. Those are all my ingredients. So that they have their input, and then I could mash it all together and put my input out there, and boom, we made a beautiful cake.
Yeah, you'll make this giant bonanza of a camera cake.
Could be edible. Who knows?
Oh, wow. I mean, I hope I can eat it.
Yes. Not physically.
Now we got to do a cooking show.
We are.
Are we going to be baking?
No, actually, I mean, we're not going to do...
But can we?
We can if you like, but it's with King Smoke Rings.
I was going to say, we get the little hats on and the aprons, and we're just in there with flour.
Do you want to talk about that?
Tossing the
About what?
The King Smoke
about
Rings.
About the potential baking show?
Yeah.
The baking show or with Glenn?
I know. Do you want to tell the people about that?
About Glenn or about baking? Well, I know that we're planning on making commercials for each department, and we're all going to be bakers. Or cooks or chefs, you know. So then it'd be like, yo, Jar, this is Jar. He's the chef of editing. And then these are the ingredients that he uses to make you a beautiful dish.
That's fire.
Yeah.
I didn't even know about that. That's dope.
I mean, it's all, you know, it's all ideas for now until we can get a handle on everything else. And then so, and then we'll start doing the fun like productions and stuff like that. Yeah. Oh, I mean, you have to be part of it, part of the marketing team. You know, you could be like the sous chef. Yeah, we're cooking it up. This
plus
is
soon you're gonna catch me as the chef for sales. So
heyo, shout out.
Yeah. Yeah. So I gotta ask, what's the big dream vision for you? Where do you want to take CCN? Where do you want to go? What is your big goal with all of this?
Oh, honestly, I can't see beyond what we're doing now, and this is. Dare I say this is part, I mean, I'm living the dream right now. You know what I mean? Like I have access to a team. I have access to a studio. Everyone is open to ideas. Everyone inputs ideas. Everyone, we can all get together. Like I love how each one of us has our own ideas. And once we have the time, we can like call out who we need to bring in and be like, hey, I have this idea. What do you think? Because I do this with Joel and Jar, Jalon. I mean, Jalon's always involved because I need him for set design. Yeah, and then, you know what I mean? Like, any chance I get, like, I would love you to do interviews for everybody. But, like, as far as, like, Long River is concerned, I'm always hitting up Joel to be like, hey, what do you think of this? Like, I need help with this. And I can actually do that instead of going to Google and be like, Google, I am stupid, help me do this. AI, ChatGPT, help me out. You know, I don't have to do that anymore. And as far as like, ever since I got here, my mind does not shut up anymore. Like it's just constantly coming up with ideas, like doing a cooking show for Glenn. Yeah. You know what I mean? And
that was you?
Well, he wanted to do a promo for himself and the sponsor that sponsored the show. But I was like, we can do that. That's fine. But let's just do a cooking show. You're going to show me how you made the meat that day and how you injected it with this beer. Let's just turn that into an episode.
That sounds like a good episode to me. I'd like to watch that.
Yeah, I mean, I'd like to film it just so I can eat after. Right? Like, yeah, exactly.
I concur with popular opinion.
Yeah, so you know what I mean? And there's like so many talented people that's willing to listen, that's willing to input, that has good ideas, and we're like working together scarily, I don't know if that's a word, scarily well.
Yeah.
Because there's not a lot of headbutting here, which is kind of crazy.
You'd be surprised with the team that is as diverse as us. We mesh pretty well together.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, there might be a little bit of irritation just because, you know, some of us are tired, but that comes with the territory.
Yeah. And we all know it's nothing serious. It's just like, damn, bro, I need a break. Give me 1 second.
Yeah.
Well, cultivators, it's been great coming up with the virtuoso, the legend himself, Masaya. I'm going to catch you guys in the next one.
Peace.